Do you worry about your schoolworks?
Me, as a student, I worry a lot. People know what the internet is. It's a worldwide computer network made up of interconnected networks that use standardized communication protocols to provide a variety of information and communication services.
Have you ever tried to use the internet for school activities? Do you usually rely on internet answer for your paperworks? Are Wikipedia, Google, Brainly, and other academical websites are familiar to you? As many people know, some students rely on the internet to answer their assignments. The point is, do they even understand the question which are asked? Internet answer helpful for the student? We use Google Classroom or Zoom in our online class. I know all of you heard about Brainly, but let's differentiate the use of Google Classroom to Brainly and other academical websites. Google Classroom is a virtual classroom that's like a regular classroom, discuss a lesson, and gives activities and modules. From this, we learn by listening to the explanation or discussion of the teachers. We can also read the modules supported by our teachers. While Brainly and other academical website is a website that anyone can ask or give an answer to whoever asks. You can effortlessly type the question, and also we can get the answer we're looking for. We can get extra information about the topic for our schoolworks. It's time now to discuss the good and bad effect of using internet for our schoolworks. Firstly, good effects are your answer can be informative. It's also easier than reading a book. That's why it's less time consuming to find the answer. You can also learn and discover new things that can help in your schoolworks. However, the bad effects are copy-pasting the answer. Of course, it's easier to copy from a website. It can also lead to plagiarism. Students also lose skills at thinking as well as misunderstand the answer to the question being asked. Now, let's talk about how we can avoid becoming overly dependent on the internet. Using the Pomodoro techniques, it improves planning, good for productivity, helps fight procrastination, and deals with distraction and interruptions. Setting goals is important. It is also useful for taking notes in addition to journaling. It can boost memory by writing information by hand. It enhances your critical thinking skills. And lastly, getting rest is important. Taking a break improves our ability to learn new information and form memories. It can also restore your energy and reduce stress. It helps you think more clearly. To sum up everything, we use Google Classroom or Zoom in our online class. Google Classroom is a virtual classroom where the teacher discusses a lesson and gives activities and modules. While Brainly and other academical website is a website that anyone can ask or give an answer to whoever asks. The good effects of using the internet for school are your answer can be informative and less time consuming. While the bad effects are copy-pasting and it can also lead to plagiarism. We can avoid it by using Pomodoro technique. It improves planning, good for productivity, and fight procrastination. Taking a break restores your energy and reduces stress. It helps you think more clearly. And I believe in a quote that, technology is a useful servant but a dangerous